Yahoo Fantasy Baseball, Tucson Toros Group, Week 7. We're going to take a look at Tucson's prettiest, taking on AZ Padres in Week 7. Getting straight to the final score. It looked like Padres lost this one 3-6-1 to Tucson's prettiest. Prettiest now improves to 37-28-5 on the year, while Padres is now 30-32-8. TP wins for the first time in 3 weeks after starting out 4-0, so definitely a bounce-back victory for Tucson's prettiest, while AZ Padres ends a three-week winning streak and falls below 500 again. For highs and lows, Tucson's prettiest picked up highs for the season in runs, homers, RBIs, average wins, and Ks. Fantastic statistical week for Tucson's prettiest. We'll get into that a little bit more just ahead, but AZ Padres had season highs in runs, average, and wins. So definitely gave Padres a run for its money, or prettiest. I'm sorry, it's a run for its money in a couple of categories. But let's just break things down. Offense went 4-1 to Tucson's prettiest. Pitching was a split 2-2-1 between the two teams. On offense, Tucson's prettiest had a monster week. Record highs in four categories, and get this, had two players on the DL, and two players that are NA. Used just eight players this week, and this was a beneficial week to teams that aren't setting their lineups, as every team played 7 days this past week in baseball. So if you weren't setting your lineup, you had just as much a chance, as long as your rosters were actually reflecting active players. But in this case, Tucson's prettiest didn't even need active players and still put up record numbers for that squad. All players on the offense had at least one run for TP, and five players had at least six runs. All players had at least an RBI, and five players had at least six of those. Five players had an average of 355 or higher. Fantastic week in average for Tucson's prettiest. Three players hit three-plus homers each, and Kevin Youkilis, 4 homers, 10 RBIs, 8 runs, and a 409 average for the week. Just an explosive week for Kevin Youkilis. For AZ Padres, used all 15 offensive players. A very interesting strategy, considering you could have just left the lineup the way it was and still got in seven games for every player in the lineup. A lot of players, or a lot of teams, went that route this week, but Padres decided to rotate people in and out. Don't know if it really helped or hurt, though, to be honest. Nine players had at least three runs, and there was an incredible battle in this matchup in the average category. AZ Padres had 10 players hit over 300, but the lack of the long ball really cost AZ Padres this week. Fewer home runs. Andrew Jones, for example, he's been a great source of homers to start the year. No homers and hit 091 for the week, so rough week there. Jumping over to the pitching side, it was very tight in all five categories. 5-4 battle and wins went to AZ Padres. There was a tie in saves. 41-35 in Ks went to TP. 2.3 ERA versus a 2.39 ERA going to AZ Padres. And a 1.24 whip versus a 1.35 whip in favor of TP. So all five categories very hotly contested. This matchup could have easily went Padres' way had a couple of things gone differently. Bright spots for TP, Mike Pelfrey back on track after a couple weeks of struggling. Picked up 2 wins and a 1.98 ERA. Definitely helped out the team there. An excellent battle in the ERA category. Francisco Cordero cost the team the ERA category. Basically handed it to AZ Padres with really erratic pitching, but also locked down 2 saves to tie that category and force a push there. For AZ Padres, there were 2 wins from Josh Johnson. He had a great week, gave up no runs. And Heath Bell had 2 saves and a 0 ERA. Unfortunately, though, Fernando Rodney, a 9 ERA and no saves. He's now the setup man for the Angels, so his saves are going to be few and far between, especially with Brian Fuentes getting things a little bit closer to back on track, at least this past week. Looking ahead, Tucson's prettiest is now 5th in the standings, 7 games out of first, and it's going to be taking on mid-packer Koufax's Revenge. And AZ Padres, 9th, right in the middle of that dogfight, in the middle of the pack, 5 games out of 6th, and it's going to be taking on Lucky, one of the teams in the bottom of the league right now. Going to be a very important matchup for Tucson's pretty to try to get some momentum back, stay in that top six. There's definitely a lot of teams chomping at the bit to get in the top six. And for a team that's not setting its lineup, once you're out of that top six, it's going to be hard to climb back out of that hole. AZ Padres definitely putting up a real strong fight. A lot of effort out of this team. You just love seeing that, especially early in the season. And taking on Lucky. Lucky's a team that has yet to really put forth a whole lot of effort as far as trying to pick up wins and set lineups. So Padres should pick up the win in that one. We'll look forward to seeing what happens at the end of week 8 in Tucson Toros.